With a rigging setup on your character that makes animation easy, in this video, we will quickly go through the process of setting up character rigging and then animating with that rig in just a few minutes. To create a character in the first place, I prefer to use Photoshop, but you can use other tools as well. If you want to create a character, start by creating a new project and designing your character. Be careful to put each part of the body in a separate layer. As you can see, I am using this character from Kinney. There are too many 2D characters to choose from, and they are all free. The instructions said to put each part of the body in a separate layer, so I did that, and this is what I got. Each body part is in a separate layer, so let's export it into our project. Go to your project folder, select Large Document Format, PSB, and save it. Change mesh type to full rect to use all the space around the character. Now, as you can see, the imported file has multiple layers, each containing an individual body part. Before trying to make bones, let's make sure we have a complete 2D package that includes a 2D PSD importer and 2D animation in our package manager. Select the character and open the sprite editor. If auto-slicing each layer does not look good, make changes and save them before creating bones. At the top, select the skinning editor. Here, you can create bones or edit them and do other features. Select the Create Bone option and start placing bones, considering the anatomy of your character's skeleton. Click and drag up to place a new bone, and right-click to stop doing that. Alternatively, you can go back to the top of the previous bone or any other bone you placed and click and drag from there. After you finish, under the Geometry tab, select Auto Geometry. There are a few options here. Make sure you enable the weights, and the main option is the subdivide option. This option will break down each one of these sprites like doing mesh in a 3D game, and the higher the number, the more details it is. For now, I will leave my settings as default. When that is finished, you will notice that our guy is shaded in all different colors. If you go to the preview pose and try to move the bones, you will notice that the sprite moves with it, which means it is successfully rigged. However, it is still sloppy at this moment. This is where weights come into play. We have a tab called Weights, and we just need to manually set how each bone can have an influence on the sprite. For example, I don't want the right leg bone, which is green, to have an influence in this middle part of the body. So, I will select the weight brush and then select the red bone in the middle part of the body and draw where the green color is. I will continue for each individual bone to get a better result. Note that this may happen when the auto weights couldn't make it good because of the anatomy of our body or badly placing the layer. After putting in some time, I finally got a better result. Be sure to apply the changes and let's get back to the editor. Here, as you can see, I have a new game object bones, and if we expand this, you will notice each one of these bones has been created. If you can't see the bones in the scene view, just enable the gizmos. We have finally rigged up a character, and it's all ready to go. So what should we do now? The main purpose of rigging a character is to create animations quickly and easily, so let's get started on that. First, let's add an animator component to our player. In the assets folder, we can create a new animator controller named player controller. Then, we can open up the animation window and hit the create button. Once created, we can enable the recording mode and start at the beginning of our animation. Our goal is to get our character to an idle pose, so to achieve this, we can adjust the arms and create a breathing effect by increasing and decreasing the scale of the body bone. Try to have a look around the skinning editor and make some animation to understand how it works and how you can make the best out of it. I am excited to introduce you to a new Unity asset called Rainbow Jump. It's a complete casual mobile game template that comes packed with several features such as easy customization, clean and commented C# scripts, sound effects, background music, increasing gameplay difficulty, randomly generated obstacles, customizable obstacle spawning system, and an infinite runner. This asset is also suitable for educational purposes. The creator of this asset has generously offered the first 3 people who like, retweet, and comment on the post a free copy of Rainbow Jump. So, hurry up and be the first to grab this exciting opportunity. Thank you for watching, and I would love to hear your thoughts. Looking forward to seeing you soon.